I think that was the year of 2018. That was one of the lowest point in my life, probably most lowest point in my life, because so I just recently got divorced. And then a few months later, I was diagnosed with hyperthyroidism, and it affected my vocal cord, in which I felt like I lost all my confidence level. Karena vocal cord is my asset, gitu. This is how I make a living. I make a living out of singing, and so knowing that I wouldn't have the stamina that I used to have before, when it comes to singing, it made me so upset and angry about myself. And I was actually thinking of ending my career, you know. But I learned something, that when you were at your lowest point of your life, you would only need one person, just one person who would remind you again why you started this off, you know. And I found that through my producer, producer yang memproduceri album Inflammable, Aditya Randra, gitu. I remember we were both in pain, and then we talked about it, and then he was offering me to make, in the beginning it was just for a one song, this one song that we made together, yang akhirnya ada di album juga, judulnya Storm Won't Last Forever. Tapi dari situ akhirnya kayak berlanjut dan segala macam. Dari situlah akhirnya gue kayak memahami bahwa gue harus bisa lebih open up lagi sama orang-orang gitu. Because I used to be like so introverted, like I keep everything to myself. Tapi akhirnya setelah gue ngebuka diri, gue you know, like confiding in someone, gue ngerasa lebih terbuka gitu, jalan lebih banyak terbuka aja, you know, learning how to open up my emotions to people. Yang gue belajar satu sebenarnya, sometimes like when you're so introverted and you don't feel like the need to open up to somebody else, is probably because you haven't really communicated your emotions within yourself to yourself. Jadi saat itu gue kayak berusaha mengerti dan mengkomunikasikan ke diri gue lagi sebenarnya apa sih yang gue rasain. Gue tuh marah, I was angry, I was sad, I was upset gitu. Dan gue berusaha kayak ngobrol, bener-bener kayak ngobrol sama teman sendiri gitu, kayak Ra, you're sad gitu, you're sad because of this and this and this gitu. Dan gue ngerasain saat lo udah bisa memahami itu, lo jadi bisa membuka diri lo ke orang lain gitu, karena lo sudah bisa mengkomunikasikan itu ke diri lo sendiri gitu. So it's gonna be easier for you to communicate it to other people gitu. Eventually we're like, humans are social beings. There's no point of like living if you don't share what you actually feel, what you actually, you know, experience. Jadi menurut gue itu pentingnya lo mengkomunikasikan segala apapun yang lo rasain dulu ke dalam diri lo sebelum mengkomunikasikan ke orang lain gitu. And it's, trust me, it's gonna be a lot easier. Kadang bisa mempengaruhi banget sih. One of the things that is actually recent is that tentang album ini. Jadi waktu itu gue, my cover artwork, the album, Inflammable, itu gue bikin sendiri, cause like I actually am a visual artist as well. Terus gue bikin sendiri, walaupun yang fotograf the picture was Zaki Muhammad gitu, cuman gue desain sendiri dan segala macam. And then I put out the artwork on Instagram. And then a few moments later, just like 2 hours later after I posted that cover artwork, a friend of mine, a good friend of mine, called me up and then he said, I know, gue tahu intention dia baik sebenarnya gitu, cuman mungkin caranya aja yang salah. He said, kok cover artworknya agak dangdut ya, dia bilang gitu. Terus gue ngerasanya kayak Nyiroro Kidul. I remember that exactly. Terus dia sempat bilang juga bahwa karena lagu-lagu lo tuh bagus, makanya gue care banget. Tapi gue ngerasanya ini pizza tapi dibungkus pakai nasi apa bungkus nasi uduk, dia bilang gitu. Terus me being super, you know, unexpecting of that thing to have ever emerged, you know, gue kaget, terus gue sempat upset, tapi walaupun gue biasanya kayak, you know, coba mencerna dulu opini orang lain dan segala macam, tapi kadang kalau lo lagi nggak apa ya, lagi nggak waspada gitu, kadang-kadang bisa kena gitu. And then what happened was that gue akhirnya doubtful sama artwork itu. Gue sampai akhirnya nge-hire 3 fotografer dan desainer lagi untuk bikin artwork. Sampai gue kasih ke Andra gitu, Andra ini bagus gak, ke beberapa temen, like my good friends juga. And then I was asking for their opinions, bagus yang mana segala macam. Tapi kebanyakan milih yang album dengan that, you know, purple dress in the tunnel itu gitu. Cuman gue masih doubtful gitu kan. Terus akhirnya itu nge-impact sama perilisan album. Perilisan album sempat apa namanya membingungkan, and it got delayed for like a day. It's because artworknya ganti-ganti. Artworknya gue sempat minta si Andra ini apa segala macam gitu. Tapi akhirnya pada akhirnya apa yang kita pakai itu adalah artwork yang pertama. Balik lagi ke artwork yang pertama. Dan akhirnya gue jadi kayak belajar lagi gitu, apa namanya, the power of believing in yourself gitu, bahwa kalau if you believe in something, udah stop di situ gitu. Orang boleh ngasih lo opini, but if you, karena lo yang, cuma lo yang tahu tentang proses pembuatan karya lo gitu, lo yang paling mengerti, so you just have to put 100% faith in yourself when it comes to making a decision about everything, like the artwork, music, and everything. Balik lagi album ini, like this is a total different sound, a total different image and character. Gua yang dulu orang label like kayak this, you know, I was having this dark character, always sad songs, dark songs and everything. All of a sudden, I came up with like this bright sounds, you know, bright vocals. Everything is so bright gitu. Jadi kayak gua sempat mempertanyakan ke diri gue if I would wanna do this if I'm so sure about it gitu, karena gue tuh I'm very observant apalagi terhadap sesuatu yang baru gitu. Jadi pas Andra datengin gue untuk bikin sesuatu yang baru tuh gue mikir keras banget gitu, how am I gonna, you know, adjust to this new sound gitu. Tapi pada akhirnya gue ngerasa the more I open up to things, the more, you know, the universe built bridges and pathways for me to, like, you know, discover something new. That's the beauty of it, I think. Dan itu sih pertimbangan yang paling penting menurut gue saat sebelum apa proses merilis album ini. Gue cuma berharap mereka happy listening to this, to the songs, to the album. Gue pengen mereka joget gitu. Although I have to be honest, like some of the lyrics, walaupun lagunya joget, tapi lyricsnya masih dark. I think that's just me. I think I was born with it. This is based on my personal experience. You know, when you were at lowest point in your life, gitu, you could still make it. Man, you could still make it. I mean, everybody suffers probably a whole lot of pain silently, gitu. And I've experienced that, but I just hope that this album would remind you that, you know, I was from the ashes, I was from zero. Saat itu gue nggak tahu lagi harus kayak gimana terhadap hidup gue dan gimana cara memulainya untuk bangkit lagi tuh susah banget gitu. But then again, I'm here still living life, breathing. So I hope that this album, the message of this album, would finally get delivered to your heart and you could find yourself in between the songs.